Okay, we shall continue the chapter Transportation Human Being. Last class we discussed about the heart and its working, and I also explained that in higher of animals like birds and mammal there is double circulation, and double circulation means from the heart blood goes to the lungs and again come back to the heart, then from the heart to the body and again come back to the heart, meaning before it complete one full circulation, actually it comes two times to the heart, and there is no mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood in higher organism. This is very important in higher animals like even human being, because we have to maintain a constant body temperature. In organism like birds and mammal, body temperature remain constant. Human being, it is 37 degrees centigrade, so it remains constant. To maintain this 37 degrees centigrade, we need lot of oxygen. So the circulation, there is no mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood in higher organisms. But in lower animals like fish, even frogs, amphibians, you can see fish, only the heart is made up of only two chambers, one atrium and one ventricle, only two chambers are there, and we have four chambers. So in what is happening in fish is the blood comes to the heart, it is pumped down to the ventricle and this atrium, and it comes to the atrium. This diagram is not there in your textbook. And when atrium, this one contract, blood moves down to the ventricle. In a higher organism, four chambers are there. And from here, when ventricle contract, blood directly go to the gills. Fish, you can see the breathing organ of fish is gills. You can see it is going to the gills. It will go to the gills, and then again after taking oxygen, gill is the respiratory organ in a fish, like our lungs, gills are there. Namukariyam gills, ariyavunnana fish in the gills. And from gills, the blood after purification, oxygenation, it will go to the body. It will go to the body after deoxygenation, after removing, after oxygen is finished. Again, it will come back to the heart. It is coming back to the heart. So this is called single circulation. And lower organisms like fish, this single circulation is enough because they are not maintaining their body temperature constant. Fish body temperature changes according to the environment. It can go up or down, no problem. So their oxygen demand is less. So this is where. And then one more thing I explain. Okay, ventricular contraction, at the time of ventricular contraction in human being, pressure produced, blood pressure is very high. So at the time of ventricular contraction, you can see pressure will be very high. And ventricular contraction, then at the time of ventricular relaxation, ventricle lower chamber, at the time of ventricular relaxation, the blood pressure will be less. And this is actually, when we take the blood pressure of humans, you can see the maximum high pressure is also called a systolic pressure. Systolic means contracting, the pressure developed during contraction. It is 120, and at the time of relaxation, of ventricle, the pressure is 80, that is the normal temperature. And there is a pressure gauge, instrument measuring human pressure. And that is actually called spikemomanometer. That is already there in the textbook. You can see the diagram, everything is there. So we have to remember the normal pressure in a human being. And also, it is called systolic pressure and diastolic pressure. High pressure and low pressure, we say, commonly say high pressure and low pressure. And diastole means relaxation. Systole means contraction. This is where we stopped the last time. Now let us talk about the blood vessels. once again, blood vessels. If you examine the blood vessels of a human being, you can see human heart. So aorta is starting from the left ventricle and it is going to different parts of the body. You can see this aorta. This is any blood vessel which carry blood away from the heart, it is called an artery. Away from the heart, it is called artery. So this blood vessel carry blood to all part of the body. When it reaches different parts of the body, for example, when it is going to the down part, leg, or other part of the body, you can see it will branch, rebranch, and it will become very small branches. You can see finally it will become very thin, unicellular branches, very thin branches. So when it become very thin, only one cell thick, and this time the arteries, when it carry blood to different parts of the body, these are all cells. Let us see, these are the cells of human being. When it reaches different parts of the body, you can see they will become very thin, called capillaries. Capillaries, and these capillaries, again they reunite, again they become many capillaries, they join. Capillaries from different parts, they join again, and it will become bigger and bigger, and finally it will come back to the heart again. It will come back to the heart as it is called a vein. You can see. So, what are capillaries? The smallest blood vessel, that is of arteries, is called the smallest blood vessel is called capillaries. And if you examine artery and a vein, artery carry blood from the heart to the different part of the body. When the blood coming back to the heart, you can see it will be, the pressure will be very low. When this ventricle contract, blood will go very fast to different parts of the body. The blood pressure is very high that time, that we have already discussed. And because of that one, this is artery. This is artery. Artery walls are very thick. So artery walls are thicker. This artery walls are very thick. Why it is thick? It is very clear because the pressure is high. Artery walls are very thick. And from here you can see it is very thick. But when it comes to vein, when it is coming back through the vein. These veins, comparatively, their walls are thin. So there is one difference between arteries and a vein. Artery, it is carrying blood from the heart to different parts of the body. So after contraction of the ventricle, the blood is going with high pressure. So the walls of the arteries which carry blood to all part of the body, that is, you can see it is very thick. But when it come back, it is coming through veins. These are veins, where it is coming through the vein. And the walls of the vein are comparatively thin. And you can see the smallest blood vessel is called capillaries. When it is coming back, when the blood is coming back from the leg, it is coming, no pumping organ in the leg, only the pressure of the heart is making it to come back. When the blood is coming back, it is you can see the pressure will be very low. So because of that one, there is a chance to blood to flow backwards. This to prevent this one. In vein, there are valves are there. Valve is what we call it. What is the aim of the valve? They allow blood to pass only one direction. And when it tries, so now blood can go this way. But it cannot come down. When it tries to come down, it will be closed. So valves are like this. The blood can go in one direction, but when it tries to come back, it will be closed like this. So you have seen some people, they are having varicose vein. Kalayiloke nokkuvaanengil ee veins okke tadichu koodiyirikkunna kaanunnu adu varicose vein. When these valves not there in the test tube, when the valves are not functioning properly, it will cause the blood may try to go backwards, and this is the reason for varicose vein. Now I already explained the function of blood platelets is to protect the blood from wound. When there is a wound, ഒരു മുറിവുണ്ടായെങ്കിൽ അവിടെ ബ്ലഡ് ക്ലോട്ട് ചെയ്ത് സോ ഇറ്റ് ഹെൽപ്പ് ഇൻ ദ ക്ലോട്ടിങ് ഓഫ് ബ്ലഡ് ആൻഡ് ദ വൗണ്ട് വിൽ ബി ക്ലോസ് സോ ദിസ് ഈസ് എ വേർഡ് ദെൻ നെക്സ്റ്റ് വൺ നൗ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ക്യാപിലറി ലെറ്റസ്റ്റ് സ്മോൾ ബ്ലഡ് വെസൽസ് ആർ കോൾഡ് ക്യാപിലറീസ് വെൻ ഇറ്റ് കം ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി തിൻ വോൾ ആൻഡ് വെൻ ഇറ്റ് കം വെൻ ദ ബ്ലഡ് കം ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കമ്മിങ് വിത്ത് എ ഗ്രേറ്റ് പ്രഷർ When the blood comes, when it flows through the capillaries, you can see a part of the blood will leak out from the capillary. A part of the blood will leak out from the capillaries. And why the blood is coming and going? It is to provide food, oxygen, everything to the cell. When blood circulates in a function to give food, oxygen, everything to the cell, also hormones and other things. And then also it has to carry the waste materials from the cell. So a part of the blood will leak out, you can see from the capillary. Capillary walls are very thin, membranous. So a part of the blood will leak out. This leak out part of the blood, it will be covering the cells. This is called a lymph. So actually lymph is produced inside the, it is produced from the blood. And what is its function? This lymph now, it contains food, and the food will be diffused into the cell. So it will provide food, and any waste, it will be collected from the cell. And again, this lymph is here. And lymph, another name is tissue fluid. It is called tissue fluid. This tissue fluid is colorless, not like blood, it is colorless. Plasma and it contains mainly plasma and mainly it contains plasma and blood plasma and other digested food. So it is carrying digested food and other things and it is giving to the cells. The lymph, it will not remain here after removing the waste and other things. You can say the lymph will be again collected by small tubes. These small tubes, lymph avade, it will not stay there, and it will be collected, the lymph will be collected, and this is called lymphatic vessels. Thirichu collect cheyyunna lymphatic vessels. And this lymph, where it will go? Again, it will go and join with the veins. Veins will not go. In the blood leg, it will join with the blood. So, and what is the function? Function is to, main function is to provide food, and also it is drains extra fluids and the cell in the cortex. It is to take the extra fluids back. So, these are the mainly about one more thing. So this is mainly about the circulation of blood and the transportation human being. So lymph is a colorless and it contains less protein. It is already given in the test tube. Once again about lymph formation. Blood is transported through the arteries, and when arteries become very, very small, and it is called capillaries. When it is very thin, through the walls of the capillaries, a part of the blood leak out, and the leak out part of the blood is called lymph. And this lymph, the function of, is exchange of materials, food and other things will be exchanged with the cell, and the waste material will be collected. And then you can see it will be later collected by another tubes called lymphatic vessels, and it will join to the vein. So this is all about human circulation. Now we are going to discuss about plant circulation of different materials in plants. So circulation in plants. transportation in plants. Not circulation, transportation. We were discussing about transportation in animal. Now transportation in plants. You can see plants, the energy requirement is very less. Why energy requirement is very less? Plants are not moving. Because of that one, plants, it doesn't move from one place to other. So because of that one, their energy requirement is less. And another thing, if you take a tree, most of the inner cell, many cells are dead. And that is another reason they need less energy. And so they need a slow transport. Not like our body pumping blood to all part of the body continuously. But in plants, this kind of very active transport system is absent. Because the reason is this one, they need less energy and they don't move. And also, slow transport system is enough. You know the transport system in plants, it is mainly xylem and phloem. This is the transport system in plant. Xylem and the phloem. So, you know the plants, they absorb various substances from the soil by using root hairs. And the root hairs are there, small roots, root hairs are there. So you can see this plant is growing in the soil. And this is the soil. And these small many roots will be there. And you can see very small hair-like roots, they are called root hairs. These root hairs, these are very small hair-like roots are called root hairs. And these root hairs, they absorb water, not only water from the soil, they also absorb other substances like so many minerals. For example, they absorb nitrogen as nitrate. So as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, all this will be absorbed. And even other so many other elements are also needed by the plants. So plants absorb magnesium. So many other elements are absorbed. So plant absorb these kind of things, water plus so many. When you put fertilizer to the soil, this fertilizer also is absorbed by root hairs. How it is absorbed? Mainly by diffusion. Diffusion means movement of materials, substances from high concentration to low concentration is called diffusion. Actually, water absorption is by osmosis. You might have studied in the lower classes. And all these substances, it will get inside the plant. Then how it is transported to the leaves? Actually, food preparation, actually photosynthesis, it is taking place in the leaves of the plant. Actually, photosynthesis takes place in the leaf of a plant. So, water and other mineral salt that is absorbed by plant, it will be going through a small tube. This small tube you studied, it is called xylem. Small tubes, already you studied, these are called xylem tubes. Mainly xylem vessels, tubes are called xylem vessels. You just studied. So this it is going up by up through the xylem vessels to the leaves. But how this, what is the energy, how it is transported? No heart. Plant is having no heart, so how it is transported? So it is transported by a simple mechanism because of what is called a transpirational pull. You can conduct a small experiment, not in the textbook anyway, experiment like this. Take a small branch of a plant, the branch of a plant with the leaves, young plant, and then connect this one with a small tube, the end connect it with a small tube, and put some water in a container. And suppose the water is up to here now. You are taking some water in the container. You can do it at home. And after some time, so the tube, glass tube or any tube which you can see. Now, after some day, you can see water will slowly go up. Slowly, you can see the water will be rising through this tube. Why it is going up? Because when plant, when water evaporates from the leaves of the plant, what is the name of that one? It is called transpiration. When water is lost from the plant, you can see more water will be sucked upwards. And this is very similar. When you are sucking some juice from using a straw, when you are sucking, more and more juice will come from the glass. Similarly, when water evaporates through the leaves by transpiration, more water will be automatically, it will be going up. And along with the water, the other minerals, salt, nitrate, phosphate, potassium, calcium, all these other minerals all dissolved in water also will be transported upwards. This is how plants, the transportation of water to the leaves takes place. So mainly, we already studied xylem vessels and xylem tracheids. They are responsible for water absorption. So, by osmosis, water will be absorbed by root rays. Osmosis we already studied. It is a diffusion through semi-permeable membrane. And from the root rays, it is transported to the leaves by the pull suction force developed because of transpiration. And this is what you call the transpirational pull. Now, food transportation, you can see it is going through the phloem. Transportation is food mainly going through the phloem. You can see phloem also you studied. Food is transported from the leaves. You can see food is produced in the leaf and it is transported from the leaves to other part of the plant. You can see it can go to different parts of the plant. It may go to the root going down. It can go to the root or it can go to fruits. If your fruits are here, it can go up or down. You already studied that phloem transport is in a different direction. Xylem only root to the leaf, but phloem transport is in a different direction. Okay. So, to get the food into the sieve tube, that is the phloem, you can see energy is used. Automatically, the food will not get inside. So how energy is stored in our body, it is or the plant body or animal body as ATP, something like a battery which store energy, and you can see it is absorbed by using with the help of companion cell also in the food is get into the phloem. It is getting into the phloem by using energy. അതായത് എനർജി ഉപയോഗിച്ച് വലിച്ച് ഫ്ലോയത്തിലോട്ട് എടുക്കുന്നു എ ടി പിയുടെ പ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന എനർജി ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ദെൻ വെൻ ഷുഗർ ഓർ ഫുഡ് ഗെറ്റ് ഇൻ ടു ദ ഫ്ലോയം ഫുഡ് വലിച്ച് ഫ്ലോയത്തിൽ കൊണ്ടുവന്നിരിക്കുന്നു വിത്ത് ദ ഹെൽപ്പ് ഓഫ് കമ്പാനിയൻസ് എല്ലാം ഓൾസോ യു ക്യാൻ സീ മോർ ഷുഗർ ഈസ് ഹിയർ സോ വാട്ടർ വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ഇൻസൈഡ് ബൈ ഓസ്മോസിസ് അപ്പം വെള്ളം കൂടുതലകത്തോട്ട് കയറും സോ ദ പ്രഷർ വിൽ ബി ഡെവലപ്ഡ് അപ്പോൾ ഫ്ലോയത്തിനകത്ത് പ്രഷർ ഡെവലപ്പ് ചെയ്യുന്നു വെള്ളത്തിൻ്റെ പ്രഷർ കൂടുന്നു സോ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബിക്കോസ് ഓഫ് ദീസ് പ്രഷർ ദ ഫുഡ് വിൽ ബി ട്രാൻസ്പോർട്ടഡ് ടു ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് ഡയറക്ഷൻ ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ഗോ ടു ദ റൂട്ട് റൂട്ട് വേണേൽ സ്റ്റോർ ചെയ്യാം ഓർ ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ഗോ ടു ദ ഫ്രൂട്ട് ഓർ എനി അതർ പാർട്ട് സോ ആക്ച്വലി ഡ്യൂറിങ് എ സ്പ്രിംഗ് സീസൺ യു ക്യാൻ സീ ഫുഡ് സ്റ്റോർഡ് ഇൻ ദ റൂട്ട് റൂട്ടിൽ സ്റ്റോർ ചെയ്തേക്കുന്ന ഫുഡ് സ്പ്രിംഗ് സീസണിൽ ലീഫെല്ലാം പോയി പുതിയ ബഡുകളും ഒക്കെ വരുമ്പോഴത്തേക്കും യു ക്യാൻ സീ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി ട്രാൻസ്പോർട്ടഡ് ടു ദ ബഡ് So this is, it can go in different direction. Transportation method is different. Xylem and phloem transport are different. So xylem transport, you can see water from the root to the leaf by transpiration pull. Phloem transport, you can see the food get into the phloem by using energy. Energy ഉപയോഗിച്ച് അകത്തോട്ട് വലിച്ചു കയറ്റുന്നു. And this energy is from ATP, which you will study later again. And you can see when this food, for example, sugar get inside, you can see it will mix with water and then water pressure will be increased because of the high pressure you can see in the food will be transported to different parts of the body. So this is the end of transportation in plants. Next we are going to see excretion next class. Try to answer the questions given in the question paper, in the textbook, and then we will discuss. I will give some more questions later. So that is okay. Now, if you have any doubt, we can discuss the doubt on Saturday. Okay.